from South Carolina is recognized.
Yeah, it's pretty obvious in this conversation. We're not going to convince anybody's, change anybody's mind. Dr. Van Drew, and thank you for bringing this resolution up. You've been, they brought up the fact that it doesn't get the job done. It's needed to take this in front of the American people because you got a president that is not going to do the job. Would you agree to that?
I agree. It's a roadmap and a plan for action.
And are the numbers just from when Donald Trump left, are the numbers just made up of the number that are coming into this country? South Carolina has 5.2 million people. We've now got, that we know of, over between 9 and 12 million. Is that a made-up number?
Congressman, there are not made-up numbers. It's a reality, and it's significantly more, geometrically more, than what existed during the Trump administration. Facts are facts.
Are the executive orders, the 93 that he did this on, is that a made-up number?
Congressman, it's not a made-up number. He made it part of his campaign. He was very active in stating that he wanted to reverse that everything that was done at the border by President Trump.
And why is he? Why is Biden doing this? Why do you think? What's the goal for him to relax and to keep? I mean, my friends on the other side said it's been broke for 30 years. We've never had this kind of influx of illegals in this country. Why are they doing it?
Congressman, we've never had it, and we got to button up the border before we can change the immigration system. And I truly believe, and again, it's been said to me by folks, and it's even, some folks have been quoted in the media as well, saying that this is going to enable to change the census, as we discussed before, which will change congressional redistricting, which will change the Electoral College, which will assume that only one side can ever win an election again.
That's, you hit it on the head. You've been to the border, haven't you?
I have multiple times, Congressman.
I've been twice. Have you seen the cardboard with numbers on it?
I have not, Congressman.
Well, the guy talking about the plane, coming back from McAllen, we had probably of about 220 seats, probably 200 of them were illegals coming in this country that the NGOs were paying for. What about the gotaways? Is that 1.8 million estimated? Is that just made up?
It's a real number. It's a real concern. It includes people that are on the terror watch list. We know we've gotten just about 300 have been caught, but numbers of others have escaped. It includes Chinese nationals that have a relationship with the Communist Party in China. We don't know why they're here, what they're doing, where they're going. And this is not just me saying it. I mean, in general, the other side of the aisle likes Christopher Wray, the director of the FBI, quite a bit. And he has himself expressed extreme concern about what is happening in the country. Facts are facts. We're living in a dangerous situation and altering the actual structure of the United States of America.
And he took an oath to protect and defend this country, didn't he?
Correct.
And he's violated that.
I believe that he is, and I, again, I don't like to be mean-spirited. I try to be a nice guy. I really don't, but I believe it is purely political. I do. There's no reason to do it. Congressman, if I may, just for a second, it is making him much more unpopular. So people come to us and say, why is he doing this? Because there's a chance he possibly could lose the election because of it. He's doing it because it ensures the future politically.
Yeah, and he doesn't have the stamina or the willpower to go against the far left who say let everybody in this country, doesn't matter who, including the Chinese nationals.
And again, Congressman, I believe that you're right. And, you know, if you look at the old Joe Biden, not all that many years ago, was a moderate Democrat, which I don't think there's room for them anymore. But he was a moderate Democrat. His actions as president have been very left, and I believe he's controlled by others.
And the bill that the Senate came up with was basically a fake bill that didn't do anything.
And Congressman, if I can answer that, the only thing worse than doing nothing would be to do that bill and pretend we were doing something.
That's what this president wanted.
Right. And I'm tired of that, and Congressman, I think you are too.
That bill mandated catch and release. It required no fewer than 14,000 to be processed. I had heard 5,000 a day, but 14,000. Didn't close asylum loopholes. They could claim anything. It does nothing to it. and they just wanted this as cover, because this administration knows the public has gotten, you can't fool them anymore. They see it in their cities and towns all over the country. Ms. Jayapal, I'll compliment you in one thing. You came here, you said it took 17 years. You did it legally, didn't you?
I did.
And what a disgrace it is, you did it legally, and many did. For those who did that, took the time, the money, and now to let everybody in this country with no holds barred is an atrocity, not only for America, because I don't know what your side's going to say when the attack comes and they wipe out what many say is going to be make 9/11 look small.
Congressman,
but you said it right when you said that. I think Massey asked you about the wall. You don't think the wall does any good, do you?
Congressman, I don't think that the wall is going to solve the problem.
So it's not going to solve the problem, but what about the fence that went up around the Capitol, too, when the president gave his speech? We were all in the chamber. Did that do the job?
I don't think we had a fence that went up, actually. I think that was part of the problem. Are you talking about on January 6th?
The fence that when he did his screaming match, yeah. It wasn't an address. It was a political speech, and he showed he could scream and stand up for, 62 minutes, which if you take the teleprompter away from him, he would be completely lost. He can't read a thank you note on a teleprompter.
Congressman,
that being said, did the fence do the job around the Capitol? Should it have been taken down and let the pro-Palestinians come in the building? They did it. Did it not? I'm asking. Did that fence not do the job around the Capitol?
We experienced
yes or no?
A terrible event on January
6th. No, I'm not talking about January
6th. Where there
6th.
Were insurrectionists
I,
who showed
okay,
up at
I,
the
I will
United
give
States
you the,
Capitol.
I will let you finish, but I'm not going to let you talk over me. Now, give me some courtesy. I will give you the same courtesy. I complimented you on doing it legally, and I got a simple question. You don't think the wall works to keep illegals out of America? I'm asking, did the fence keep those who may want to come into Capitol when Biden gave his political speech? Did that do the job? Did it have points of entry that people had to go in? Yes or no?
Congressman, they are two completely different questions you're asking me about. Yes, I think the fence was important because we saw what happened on January 6th.
Mr. Alpa,
Congressman, you
I'm
said
not
you
going
would give
there.
Me, but
not
you
on
said
January,
you would give
look,
me the time. You
yes,
asked me a question.
But I'm
about
not going to let you filibuster.
Congressman, you asked me a question about the fence around the Capitol, and so I was responding to you about why we needed the fence around the Capitol. It came from the fact that on January 6th, we had insurrectionists who were fueled by the former president to come to the United States who killed Capitol police officers and injured Capitol police officers. And so
I'm reclaiming my time. I don't just continue to talk, even though I'm the one asking the questions, and you just filibuster. You like to go off on this tangents of January 6th. The simple question, this is an immigration issue about the resolution that I think Dr. Van Drew is bringing up, which is going to remind, and we're going to keep reminding the American people of what an atrocity this administration is doing. The President Biden has no intention to do anything, and that's a fact now. So, but the analogy of the fence around the Capitol and the fence around America, I can't for the life of me see your thoughts that it's two different issues. It's just a smaller perimeter where the country will have a designated points of entry. It's paid for God's sake. It's paid for. And this president, with violating this country from a safety standpoint, and I don't know what you're going to say when the attack comes by illegals who now number on the catch and release. It's 20,000 Chinese communist nationals in this country. 20,000 that this president has blood on his hands when something happens. And I resent it, and I resent the fact that all this talk is just nothing but talk. The American people aren't buying that. And the catch and releases and the
the children that are unaccounted for. I've heard various numbers. That's what's unconscionable. And that's what is the American people going to hold Joe Biden accountable for, because he did it on his own. Dr. Van Drew, thank you for bringing this up, and we'll continue to let the American people know what's happening. I yield